Welcome to the Empire, buddy. This is Rampaned, and welcome back to my Kingdom of Sweden campaign for the Bulat Steel mod. We're going to continue where we left off from last time. I'm trying to reclaim Sala right now, and they have some reinforcements. Which, not the worst. This is just all garrison. That I'm not too worried about. They do have a general here. And then this guy. So, I've got better quality troops most, like, all around. This guy's actually pretty good, these guys are pretty good, but their infantry, for the most part, are a bunch of levies. So, we'll try and see if we can hold them at bay here and reclaim our settlement. I do have some guys that are making their way over here, they're not going to get in here in time, and I'll probably pull them back if we lose, so that they won't be just targeted after these guys are destroyed. I'll have to make sure that we have a proper force together before we make our way back over here. Although, I could have assaulted this if I would have remembered to build my fucking siege equipment. Ooh, are we on a mountain? Yeah, we're in a pretty hilly region. So, the enemy reinforcements should be coming from up here. So, I actually want to try and be over here, which... it's kind of downhill. Technically, I can maybe be... Oh, this is worse. What about over here? Because this area is... Does have the high ground. It's not as far away from the enemy. I think I will go over here. They didn't have a ton of skirmishers. And also, that's not my strong suit with this fight here. I've got 3 infantry units and 3 cav units. Oh god. Okay, well, let's see what we can do here. Because I've got some good cav. You guys are actually pretty decent. You've been able to retrain. I'll have to have you guys try and take out their general as quickly as you possibly can. The reinforcing army I'm not too worried about, simply because that is primarily just a bunch of garrison troops. As long as I take out their general, I should be okay. I'm gonna have you guys kind of make your way around over this way. The captain for this force was... Oh, it's not the ballista. So it's this cav unit right here. So you're the guy that I care about. I'm gonna kind of hope he maybe decides to charge at me, as right now I don't have a really good way to get rid of him. Come on. Sometimes you guys like to throw your guys at me ahead of time, so let's have it so that... let's have you guys stay back here. I'm gonna have one of you go and get rid of the ballista. As they only had that one cav unit. Oh, actually, they are kind of spaced out a little bit. Never mind. If they're spaced out like they are now, I will stake my cav. Let's run around, kill you, and get rid of the ballista as well, because as soon as you're dead... Even though I don't have much... Oh, wait, actually, you can all... Yep, all of you can. All of you guys can do shield wall. Fuck it, let's do it. Everybody in shield wall formation! We are outnumbered. We don't have many men, so we'll make sure that when they charge us, they will meet a wall of shields. So you guys do that. Cav. Let's see. Yeah, he is vulnerable. He's right there. The Druznia. Druznia, we will be able to beat that back pretty easily. I'm gonna have you charge that ballista. You two specifically just charge the general. This is the side he should be on, so hopefully we can just kill him on the first charge. Ooh, we took a lot of damage there. Okay, you, as soon as you're done with that ballista, he's already dead.
Our men have slain the enemy.
Okay,
general.
We can get out of here.
Now his men will lose heart.
Pull away. I don't need to stay here. I don't need to stay here and fight your infantry. I now need to get back over to my reinforcements, or to my forces. Get over here. Now I can start cycle charging you guys as you start trying to fight us in melee. So my cap, I need you to get back over here as quickly as you can. Just kind of sneak around. Here they come. We've got our dismounted Radars. Already taken out 4% of their forces so far. I don't like some of the javelins they've got. I have to kind of charge from the side. I can't get a pretty good, really good line of sight for a charge on the back. Just have you guys kind of keep going around over here. Because number-wise, 5-5. Come on, I need to really take advantage of breaking them. Okay, here are my cav units. So I have you guys charge there. There. They are wavering already. Let's show them what we're made of! Come on, break these bastards. There you go. Okay, that unit's broken. Keep charging into those axemen if you can. Ignore this levy spearman. They're bringing that Druznia of theirs back in. Yeah, break them down. Do finish off the Druznia. Finish them off. You guys are eager, so I'm going to want to try and get away from you as soon as possible. Come on, because I want to start running these guys down. Okay, keep trying to chase them if you can. Got a couple skirmishers. I'm not too worried about them, though. Let's see, 16 and 26... 15 and 26. Run down these guys. Those are some of their better units. And then let's charge back in here. Yeah, all these guys are breaking. There we go. And here I was worried we might not be able to take this. The general they have, that is from the reinforcements, he is a named general, so he's actually going to have a pretty good bodyguard, so he'll be something to worry about. You guys over here, though. You guys kind of going back over this way. Cav, let's kind of run you back up and around. Let's go get rid of those archers of theirs. And then this guy should be pretty easy to break. You guys can actually just run right there. They don't seem to be chasing all that much. So yeah, let's get rid of these archers. The weather is clearing up for us at least. So we can actually kind of see enemies properly now. Because let's see, you guys here wavering. Troop militia, they're shaking. Just ignore them. Run down the archers. And then let's kind of get back over this way. I will have to make sure I actually kill the other enemy general. Because I'm worried he might just run away. And if he does, I'm not going to get the city. Although I did make sure to to actually build my siege equipment. So I should be able to just walk into the city next turn. Although they will have a garrison force as well. Let's see. I think that's it for all of you guys. Now it is just this general here, which I outnumber him. But this bodyguard is actually pretty good, so it's going to be difficult to take him out. Now, I'd love for us to be able to focus down the enemy general, but I don't think I'm going to be able to get that opportunity initially. Let us first instead focus on... Got some of the garrison cav over here, garrison infantry. They're just standing there at the moment, not doing anything. I might actively be able to try and take you guys, kind of run over here and run over here. Oh, they're moving again. I'm going to try and see if I can get rid of some of the dudes on the flanks early on, as these infantry units are really bad. And so it should be pretty easy for us to hopefully break them, even if the general's not dead yet. Because there's 28 guys here. I do outnumber them with my cav, but I need to make sure he doesn't get away. So I'll have to hope that he is going to get stuck on somebody, and then I can try and fight him there. Yeah, you guys, if you can take out some of these garrison infantry units, that'll make it a bit easier for my guys to not be overwhelmed. They're not good units, but the enemy does have a lot of guys, and so that's something we'll have to be careful of. Their enemy general is just chilling there. Please shoot him. Although, if he's doing this now... There you go. Shield wall made sure you guys didn't take that many casualties. Let's just charge in here. Actually, charge this... Oh, that's a levy spearman, actually. Hold off there for a second. Let's actually have you come over here. This is another garrison spearman I think I can kill. Let's kill you. The enemy general's got 26, so he's lost a couple there. But now you guys try and focus on taking these guys out while you can. Oh my god, I delete those units with those charges. Okay. Then let's get over here. Help out with this spearman. Oh shit. Left flank is not doing hot. You guys are basically out of ammo anyways, so I think that's okay. You're not my general anyways, so I'm not going to worry too much about you. I need to focus on everybody else. These guys right here, the enemy general's at 22. I'm gonna trust you guys to fight. Although, I don't want you guys to be flanked. So let's get over here now. Cav, chop out over here. Try and help out over here. Get them off of us here. And then I need to help out the left flank.
We have lost half of our men.
Like, the chances are still pretty good. We've killed about 80% of their forces right now. One of my guys ran away. I am not surprised at that at all. Let's get you guys through here. I need to charge back here. I need to get rid of this garrison cav unit. Garrison spearman. There you go. Run them all down. It's practically all their infantry dead now. They now just have their general. As long as I kill you, we should be okay. You've lost about 9 guys so far. I'm going to tell all my infantry to focus you guys. I'm going to have my cav run them down for a little bit. Make sure that none of these guys are going to want to be trying to come back. And then I just need to make sure you die. As long as you die, we get this city. Because I've killed 95% of your forces. You shouldn't be able to get back into the city as long as I kill you. Because I should have killed everything else you had. Because you had that one spearman, yourself, and then the garrison. Which, come on, where'd he go? Because I need to make sure he doesn't run away. That's my own dude. They're still fighting. There we go, finally got him. So we were able to win that. That's good, that's good. I might get a man of the hour for this, actually. We did a lot of damage.
Look at that.
Even, all of you actually got a decent amount of kills. My horsemen got the most. Infantry didn't do the worst. But not bad, guys. We should now, because, yeah, they have, like, nothing left. 95 still, yep. None of them survived, basically, so we should get Sala back. I'll have those reinforcements that were coming over here just to regroup with the city, and hope that I don't need them to stay there. So what I'd love to do is get the city situated that we can move these men out and bring them towards our reinforcements or our front line that we have with Russia, or with Novgorod, sorry, where right now we have been able to push into Novgorod. And now that, because I finally get to see how much money that city properly makes, because I know that during the end turns it's a little awkward. This was my own land. I'm going to just occupy it, as I did control the city. No need to sack it. But I know the income is a little messed up during the end turns, and so I'm curious if Novgorod is actually making 6,000. I think it could be making around 4,000. That might be realistic. But if it's actually making 6,000 right now, That'll be a pretty penny for us, and that should actively do a decent amount of damage to the financials of Novgorod, so they can't keep fielding all these armies they've got, because they've been having a lot of dudes. I know I was talking about this in the comments with the kill-death ratio stuff that Petra Robinson's been putting together for these campaigns. Still love those, absolutely love those. I still think this campaign has by far had one of the highest kill counts so far for the stage that we're at right now. Let's see, you guys want me to assault the Grand Duke of the Novgorod Principality? He's in Smolensk. Okay, so Novgorod makes about 3,500. Not actually so too surprised at that. That seems reasonable. But I'll take my king, the king that finally was able to reclaim it for, or to claim it for us. I need to get the chapel, need to start converting the area. You guys were able to take a lot of dog. You guys barely had anything survive there. I hate you. I will get reinforcements over this. I'm sad this guy didn't become a man of the hour. Which is kind of a shame. You guys are upset because of why? Religious unrest, unrest. Get the chapel again, and then let's lower the taxes for now. And then I do have these guys, which I'll keep sending up towards them. So, like, you guys and you guys make your way up here, just to make sure that they're happy. This they do have an army over here, so I'm kind of worried they might send more guys over. You might be okay. You might not be. I'm not sure. And it does seem like they are focusing their attention further to the east. So I can kind of use these areas as a... dismounted field knights. Do you guys have... You guys can use shield wall. Nice. How do you compare this? Oh my god. These guys are better. They have more armor. Lower defense skill. But overall, like, these dismounted field knights actually should be one of my best infantry units that we have. You guys do have effective against armor, but... you guys just have a higher defense, so nice. I will start gathering more of these guys, for sure. Grab those guys, and I'll be starting to use this area as a staging ground, actually. Let me do this. Let me make sure to retrain you guys. Retrain those guys first, to reinforce my guys so I don't have to continuously send them from specifically Scandinavia. Because that's kind of the main thing that's slowing us down in this expansion. Oh, they're actually are different. Dismounted mailed knights, and you guys are a little bit worse than the feudal knights. Nice, and I can only get those over here. God, this is starting to become by far my favorite, like, historical mod from BULAT STEEL TW. By far. I love this. Oh, let's see, new family member. Somebody came of age, I believe. It says anniversary, but it's not exactly what it means. Okay, knights, Stinkelly House. Let's see, because that was you. Okay, and then who's the guy that just came of age? Oh, you're an Uppsala. Let's move you. I should maybe try and send you over this way. Any more guys over in Finland? I have no fleets right now, yes, besides you. But you are trying to wait and drop these guys off. So I will have you guys disembark. And I'm going to hope, yes, I can get you guys over here to reinforce us. Because right now... Oh, I can't get people in here too. You guys right now... I'm gonna try and queue up some guys like here and here. Lithuanian cab, I think I would also maybe want. But no. Queue those guys up in case they assault us and we can kind of actually get a turn of recruitment. Because I do need some guys around here. I desperately do. You have been defending us very well down here, and I need you to keep doing that. Around here, let's get some better roads so that we can move around faster. You guys technically queue up the repair stuff and get the better chapel, but we're not gonna be able to do anything until the siege is liberated. You guys are trying to get the temple. Most of you guys are fine around here. I do need to check on the army we're going to be sending to London, as I am burning that to the fucking ground. You guys here have, like, no corruption. I can also have you guys get, like, the library to start getting better governor traits. I think I might do that. Otherwise, the animal farm, just straight up more money and more growth is not the worst. So, grab that. Anything else? You guys... basically I can recruit, like, this is all I can recruit for these cities. So for you guys here then, I think, yeah, let's upgrade the forge. I want to make sure you guys have the best armor you possibly can. So grab that. I'll probably get a farm for you guys after that. Turku, you guys have now been able to upgrade. Yeah, you've got all the military buildings that we can get for our faction. I think you guys, I might actually want to get... Oh, there is no corruption around here. I'm going to get this port. So we have at least some sort of trade hub to go talk to the other side of the sea. And then that should be... Yeah, that's it. That's it for all of that. Now... Hi, guys. So, let's take, I'm gonna take you.
Your orders, number one.
You actually are a pretty good general. Orders. I'm gonna take you to lead this army. You could use about six more guys before I have you guys make your way over here. I do need to move you guys out, as you've got all of my agents, for trade. So I'll have you guys kind of make your way down here. We're going to try and go over to Africa again. Still got that one force, which there were... Yeah, there are some slaves around here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop off at least one of you guys. Well, I can see that's 369. Yeah, that's 1500. Yeah, go trade that. Opening. Fuck this guy that's trying to trade there. Ooh, you might be able to beat me back, but I don't care. So I'm going to have you try and do that, and yes, then these guys, I think I'll just keep having you go along this way.
Now,
you're almost there, because we need to get just probably another turn now, or two. And I'll probably have you drop off maybe around here or here, because I can have you sail down the river, drop those guys off. Oh! I probably shouldn't drop you off down on the river, otherwise they'll probably get stuck by the enemy forces. I'm not at war with these guys, but still, I don't want my fleet to get stuck there. So that should be good for you guys. Let's see, this is one of my spies. I do need to kind of explore around here a little more. Can I see what's going on around here with Polosk? I am so bad at pronouncing these names. I'm so sorry. Anybody that watches this and you're a Russian viewer, I'm so sorry. So that's where their faction leader is, from what he was telling me. That is probably... It's a mission where I have to assassinate him. I might be able to do that. Let's see. Because I've got... those are my spies. Ooh, you're... Oh, you're not... You're too far away. I have this guy. You're actually pretty good. I'm going to try and send you down this way. I don't know if I'll have enough time. Nah, you're pretty far away. But you know what? We'll try it. We'll try and send you over there to assassinate him. Because we can take him out, what do we get? We'll get 15,000 florins, actually. That will not be that bad. Let's do that. Oh, I should have moved my fleet back. I should have moved my fleet back from Riga. Because I don't have any armies to move about, but I still wanted to pick up that one general that is sitting in Uppsala and then have him stop by over in Finland so I have somebody to watch over Sala. Ah, I actually lured you guys away. Okay. So you're going to attack my reinforcements before they can even get to Vilno. This army, not the worst actually, but I think we can still beat it. Balance of power is pretty close, but let's just kill these guys now as they are advancing onto us. I have no skirmishers, but I do have plenty of cav units, so I think we should be able to win this. We were able to win up by Sala, and so I would be surprised if I wasn't able to win here, because they start the battle. I have one archer. So they're attacking me. They're the only army attacking me. I'm actually gonna go up here. This is a nice, decent little hill. So set up one archer. And then I've got, how many cav units? I've got five of you? Yeah, I've got five cav units. And then a decent, like, I've got at least some of my good infantry. So all of you guys kind of line up there. You guys kind of line up a little bit more here. They do have a decent amount of cav, and so I think what I'll do is, everybody that can, let's have you guys all on shield wall formation. So they're gonna have a ton of cav, I might as well use that, because it makes it, you guys do last a lot more, a lot longer, when I have you with the shield wall because of the increased entity mass. So if you guys do that, wait for them to make their way on over to us. The captain was one of their cav units, the one in back right here. That's actually one of their weaker cav units, so it should be easier for me to kill him. Basically, I'm going to wait until you guys are separated away from your men a little bit more. Then I can try and see if I can charge in over here. So far, they are just rotating. They're not doing anything just yet. Because they've got one, two, three. They've just got three. No, four cav units. So I do outnumber them slightly with cav units. I think the quality is similar or better on my end. And so I should be able to deal with them relatively easily. Because these guys are all... Those are some horse archers. Those are some of their medium cab units. I think this is another one as well. I think this is a Druznia. Yeah, this is one of the Druznia cab units. So that guy's pretty good. These guys... I think this is their, like, medium cav one, so he's pretty easy to kill. Come on, get on up here, guys. So far, they haven't been separating their forces away yet. I think, though, let's take all my cav. Run you guys over onto this flank, and then I'm going to try and have you guys take out this unit. This guy, I'm going to be basically using you as a flanking unit, so I'll let you guys try and... Yeah, it is. Okay, so it is one of their, like, the Ognichans? Ognichans? Something maybe along those lines? But no, you guys, just run up here, deal with these guys if you can. These javelin men will die pretty easily, and then I also want you to try and take out that skirmish cav. You can easily destroy this unit. My cav is superior to them in these regards. Where the hell are you? Oh, you're right over there. Okay. Let's have you kind of go around. You're going to go immediately for that catapult. That is some of their dismounted Druznia, so get away from them.
Victory will be ours.
These guys are losing, but they are doing some damage. Get on over to those catapults. Number-wise, 3-7 so far. Not bad. Bait out cav. You guys disengage. You start going for the catapults. Get rid of them. This is the captain of theirs. Yeah, that's the captain right there. They haven't actually charged up with any of their units just yet. They're kind of waiting. You, I'm trying to have you see if you can actually do a decent amount of damage to that guy as I try and deal with their leadership around here. Those guys are all broken. Let's get you over around here. Hey, it's the captain! Okay, go kill his ass. You guys here, ignore them for now. I'm gonna have you guys kind of pull back around this way. That's a spearman. Try and kind of go around the flank race. Oh, he's already dead. Nice. Their Druznia came over here, though. Okay, so let's focus on this one first. This one should break. Then we want to make sure we get away from these spearmen. And then I need to focus on the Druznia himself. They're focusing all of their cav on me. Their infantry are making their way over. Okay, so shield wall is not going to be mandatory with how you guys are coming up at us, but I'm going to take you, I'm going to bring you onto the other side. Cav. Let's see. So now, I need to get you guys out of here. All of you. All of you guys get out of there, and then let's get rid of the ballista. Okay, one of you is stuck. Come on, go, go! We don't want to fight this infantry right now. We have no need to. Get over here. Let's get rid of the ballista. And then this guy. Okay, so they're fighting us. Let's have you kind of go around here a little bit more. They are. Oh, they're already wavering. Okay, cav, let's get you guys. After you get rid of that, we just need to focus on their infantry blobs around here. They do still have their skirmisher cav. 12 to 19. So still in our favor. I'm going to have you kind of just run up at these guys immediately. You should be able to destroy these woodsmen. We are better than you! We are you, but with armor and a better axe. Also, we have a meaner grin. We look a little bit more intimidating with our beards. Oh my god, I killed 20 guys in that charge. Nice. Okay, cav, let's get you guys. Oh, I feel like some of you guys kind of go off to the side there. You guys kind of go off to the side here. Oh, actually, never mind. There's guys over on that side I didn't see initially. Okay, everybody run over here. Run over here, and then we can make our way back to help out with them right here. You're destroying that woodsman, so I don't care about him all that much. Over here, things are devolving, so I need to get over here quickly. Come on, McCav. Because right over here is not going so hot. Number-wise, 29 to 24. I don't like that. You guys are doing a lot of damage over here. Oh, they brought the Druznia over. That's what happened. Okay. Let's get these guys. Charge the skirmishers. Some of my guys are breaking. Come on, we can still do this. I need you to break these skirmishers. Some of them breaking. Junior Druznia or not. Okay, get over here. Don't stay in melee combat for too long if it's not going to actually break the enemy. I need to get rid of you guys, though. Try and break you. Pull back once again. And then I need to... My infantry's trying to hold. You guys come up this way. Oh, Lucas is broken. Let us reform, and I'd say I need to get this blob right here.
It's unwise to praise the day.
Okay, you guys can hop out over here. You guys as well. Cav, focus on this infantry unit right here. That Druznia unit is still holding. I need to kill him if I can. There we go. These guys are breaking. And I think at this point, we have broken their infantry. I'm going to tell my infantry to start charging at them. My cav... Oh, those are dismounted troops, yeah. Ignore them. Pull away.
Lord preserve us.
Need to get away from these guys. And then adjust. So, get back over to here. We'll charge on these flanks over on this side. And we'll be able to easily kill this guy.
Victory will be ours.
There you go. Okay, so that's unit has broken. The dismounted Druzhnia have broken. At this point, they've got some archers still fighting us. And that's about it. Oh, they've got some cavs still. They've got, let's see, it's 54 to 64. But we should have this battle now. I just need to start running you guys down. There we go. You guys tried and failed to kick Captain Eskel's army's ass. So we were able to beat you guys back. Lost about half our army for it overall, but we were able to take out your entire army for the most part. I'm still hoping that I might be able to get a Man of the Hour soon. I know I have been kind of holding off on using some of my generals because they've got really bad loyalty. Although I know I can pay to get them to improve it. I'm trying to remember how you do that again. I think it was supposed to be, like, you go to their unit card in a city and right-click them or something? I can't remember. I know there's supposed to be some way that I can try and improve their loyalty. It's just been so long since it was mentioned to me in the beginning of the campaign that I just don't remember it. So, you guys are trying to attack us here again. I'm not doing the best on troops. I might lose this. I'm gonna try. We're gonna try and see what we can do. I might have to go back to the city center and hold. They have a lot of infantry, and so that might work. I'm still gonna try and use my garrison cav unit to try and get them off of the rams and everything. Because if I can get them onto the walls where I can then kind of shotgun them with my archers, that'll still do a decent amount of damage. But then also I can try and prevent them from just being able to freely walk into the city. Because I've got very little infantry. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to have you guys back here. I don't think I can have you guys stay up front. I'll use these guys, because the ladder... Okay, ladder's on that side. So what I'll do is... I'm assuming what they'll do is attack over here. So let's put my infantry here, here, and here. And then I'll have my archers. I'll have one over here. One over here. If you line up properly... Right about there. And then this guy just helping support. You guys are not going to have fire will on initially. Basically, if they push in and you guys have to fight here alone, you guys need to just be able to shotgun them. And then my garrison cab, you're fine as you are. You need to kind of run on up and get them off of their artillery pieces and their siege tower. At least the siege tower. If they get in through the ram, I'm not that worried. But the siege tower, I can't let get up because that will lag the game if they try and use it. The ladders, I'm hoping they'll use. And then the rams, I'm hoping I can also get them off of those as well. Like, you guys here, charge this unit. We've only got 20 guys, should be able to very easily get them off of that. And then let's go kind of run back over here. Spearmen, let's just get them a little bit closer. They're not using the rams, funnily enough. No, they are. Never mind. That one is. Okay, you guys. Come on, I just don't want you to shoot me. Break back up there now. Gates are shut. Good. So slow it down. Charge in here, get them off of that, and then we need to get them off of that ramp. So you know if you guys don't break. Okay, damn it! You guys have such piss poor morale, I hate it. I hate it so much. So, I don't think I'm gonna get you guys back in time.
Our enemy's ladders no, I did. Have reached our walls.
Okay, it is time. Get them off that ramp. Get them off that ramp, it's fine. No, leave me alone! I'm trying to get them off of the ramp. Here we go. Get them off of that. I don't care if you die at this point. You will fulfill your goal, and now all of their infantry are going up here. Perfect. So now what we need to just do is make sure you guys are going to unload on them here as we try and kill them up here, because my infantry is not going to last long. But what I can hope is that I will tire you guys out. They are breaking, and so they might just continue to run away, but... Tire you guys out with my infantry, and then make sure that you guys will get as many kills as soon as they get into a position where I can very easily shoot them. Then, I will have it so you guys will run back to the safe center. You can at least just shoot, because these guys are just sitting here. Oh no, again, hold off. It's easier to shoot them here instead. Because here it goes. Now we just get to see how many kills we get to get out of this. Because so far they've lost about 28% of their forces. Also, I didn't realize my base archers look badass as hell with the armor upgrades they now have. They've got some chainmail on them. I like this. Look at that. Look at these guys. These look badass, even though, like, how do their stats compare to my other guys now? The missile damage isn't that much better, but armor is pretty close, actually. Not bad, guys. I like that. I wonder if, like, you guys don't look any different at all right now. I'm curious if the next upgrade you guys will. I think you have better helmets than you did before. I think that's about the only thing that might be different. Okay, you guys aren't properly shooting all that much, so let's just try and do what you can in the last 2 minutes until the battle timer runs out. They kind of got stuck here. They were kind of having more of a rave on the walls as opposed to trying to actually fight me, which I'm okay with, as I need to make sure I hold this city long enough to get some proper reinforcements in here, as I think it's still about a turn or two until anything replenishes the unit pool, and I can actually start trying to actively get some guys around here. Because it has moved the front forward. The more castles I can take like this, the more I'll be able to push the front forward and stop focusing on the same few cities, which would be great. And also, honestly, us taking Novgorod's probably also going to help a lot, too. If I can push out of there, I need to go south, take the castle that their current king is in, and then maybe Novgorod will be fine on its own while I'm doing that? I don't know, we'll try it. Because I can execute you guys, get you out of here. We'll hold one more day. More enemy caps looted, and then I did forget to have you build us another watchtower around here. And then I think... damn it, Sala. I think that's about it for over here. I don't need to build one over there. I do need more watchtowers up here, though. So let's have you move along this way, and then I'll hold off until you're a little further along. And then, let's see. Treasure and an expansion. Oh, ooh! Finally! Okay, nice. Grab that. Put the hiring. You guys did get that trebuchet that I was asking for. Nice. I do need more ships, though, to bring along with me to... attack England. So let's get some guys from here, and then you guys as well are already recruiting some. Perfect. So you guys will grab those. I'll send them over, and then I just realized I have another general in here. Let's move you over here, and then I forgot to check because I started during the middle of an end turn. You're actually my current heir. Oh, I was about to say, like, I need to make sure my current heir is up here fighting with us, and he already is, so I'm not too worried about that. Now, he could actually move out of here right now. Because, let's see. You've got... yes. What kind of mercenaries are around here? Because if I want to go over here, I can't do it with my infantry. Are there enough mercenaries in here to get a full army? No. You've got a lot of command, man. Jesus, you're already max command. Oh, God. Okay. Then you are definitely worthy of becoming my heir. I think what I want to do, because I'll probably just do this. So let's take some of the weaker guys, merge them into the city, see what will merge. Some of you can, some of you can't. Because that's still seven of you. You guys will probably move a little further if I push through this unit, but I've already moved you guys out. Let's do this. There's 70 of you, so 1, 2, let's take the best guys. So basically, let's take you guys. Still have archers. This is going to be awkward, because I want to get you guys into Vilno. You know what? Actually, let's do this. I will have it so that... let's grab the cav. That he can actually still move. You guys can still move. Let's go bring you along with us. We're going to go over here. I'm going to kill this army, get rid of them, and then I can have you guys merge together as into one force. I want you guys to be controlled by me, because otherwise these guys can't actually fully get over to the castle. Because either I want to have it so that we have a small little force that will stay outside and take over the garrison once I'm ready, or I just want to move out now, which I don't know if we'll be able to with how many armies Kiev has around here. But let's quickly kill these guys. I should surround them, and I should be able to very easily kill them all off. So let's start the battle. You guys, transforms are off. Short battle. And then, let's see. They've got their general. Their captain is this unit right here. So I think I might want to wait for my other guys to get here. You guys, just chill all of that up. K. cav. I'm going to have you guys kind of stay back around here. As I want to wait until my reinforcements get over here before I do anything. Because they actually think they are going to turn around. So kind of group those guys up. You guys group them up as well. And then start moving forward. You guys as well. There, 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 and about there. You guys are already opening up on their forces. I forgot that I put you in front. I'll just adjust my infantry here. You guys kind of just move on up forward so they don't get charged. My cav, let's kind of go back up here. Number-wise, I've already killed 5% of their forces so far. Their captain's back here with us. So right now, I can try and have you guys kind of run on up a little bit faster. Try and group you guys together to focus down these guys. And then you can take out the captain. They actually are kind of pulling back. So they're trying to shoot us with their skirmisher cav as best they can. I'm going to bring my melee cav over here. Let's try and get rid of you guys here while we're able. That's the captain, right? Hey, captain's right up in front. Why? Why would you do that, man? Okay, you guys go there. You guys keep making your way forward here. I'm going to have you guys kind of charge there. You, honestly, the battle stop. Is in our I don't favor. Think you're going to be able to form up. If we remain true not in time. Wholehearted, victory will be ours. Oh, some of these guys are already breaking. Oh, God, okay. Yeah, go over there, help fight them. You guys, get out of there. That is a bunch of melee dudes I don't want to fight. So try and run away from them. That is their captain over there, though. Let's have you guys going to go regroup with my other cav units. I'm going to have my infantry here. I'm going to have you guys start marching forward and start trying to help us out with the enemy reinforcements. So you guys, if they're already broken there. Oh, God, yep, they are already getting into the thick of this here. Okay. The captain is right here, so I'll bring you guys back around now that he's turned his back on us. I'm going to have it so at least you two are going to just run on up over here to help out. Keep this guy right here. If we can kill him, the rest of their forces should break pretty easily. And then you guys here, what are you doing? You guys are supposed to be charging this unit here. That's not what I originally told you, but okay. You guys get back over here. We need to start trying to flank these guys. Start breaking them, because number-wise, 8 to 45. Nice. Come on, that didn't break. Okay, get out of there, my general. You guys pull back. The enemy are bad. You fight that unit for a second. They have lost. Then we can charge him on this side. There we go, now he's broken. Okay, run those guys down. You go help out over there. These guys help out there. And for the most part, yeah, okay, everything back here is dead. So I can have you guys kind of try and just... I'm going to give you generic commands of running things down. You do that. These guys here, I'm going to bring forward, as it is just this unit right here we need to get rid of. So like you guys, where'd you go? Oh, you're just charging that unit. Okay, go back around here, and let's get a charge on this guy. As soon as their captain breaks, he should be pretty easy to get rid of. So I think he's shaken. Oh, come on, die in the charge. There we go, he's broken. Run him down, and then, let's see, we're at 81. All of my infantry at this point. I would say you guys can just be on AI commands. Took a little more damage than I would have liked there, but that might actually help us with trying to merge these armies together. I should now be able to move just directly towards Villeneuve, hopefully, with my guys that I was having to reinforce us. I'll probably sit there at least a turn, and then I think we're going to try and leave here. Because I can probably leave a couple of these guys around here to just kind of watch over the city, and then we'll make our way out, and we're going to try and go for that castle tour southeast. So, actually, all of you guys... Oh, you can't get back into the city. You can. You can't. Okay... Move out. Some of those guys can merge. Let me strike, my lord. This is dangerous for you. I could just take these guys, just throw them straight into Villeneuve. Otherwise, maybe pull back for just a turn. Maybe leave these guys as they are. Leave these guys as they are, pull you back, get you some reinforcements. Yeah, let's do that. Because I know you can make your way over here. I've got a couple guys prepared, ready round here to make their way out. And then, let's see, Kalmar, you can give me some more guys as well. are coping. I'm going to actually have you focus on recruiting some more archers. You guys do that. And then Turku. Turku right now, I'm trying to have you guys will be sending most of your guys up orders. To help out with Sala. Because Sala's really unhappy. I don't know why, actually. Because it says religious unrest is like 90%, but we're already at like 40% Catholic. So I don't know what's going on with that. So let's just repair this building that does have public order, get the church again, and I just guess we have to continue trying to convert it. Even though we've already converted it once before. So we'll try that. New Cardinal for Sicily. I don't care about that. And then let's see. You guys here. Oh, man. Still a couple turns. 17 turns until I can get some of those guys around here. And you guys are all trying to repair that stuff. Just do what you can. That area is holding. Oh, my God. Novgorod's being 5,000. It's about a couple turns until you guys can actually have some dudes stay back here. I need to keep focusing on the church around here for you guys, though, to convert it faster. As right now, it's 105% right there. So let's get another priest here. And let's check and see if there are any mercenaries. There are a couple. So what I'm going to do...
Your orders,
I'm going to have you... We'll put it over here. Let's put a forge, a fort right there. And I'll have some guys sit here at this crossroad. They don't have free upkeep, but I can kind of gather some guys around here that I'll be using as a garrison for Novgorod when I feel ready to push down onto Smolensk. You guys, at the moment though, it's going to take you guys a little bit. What happened to my other navy? Because you can go down here.
Yes,
what I'll do is I want to send this guy. Going up that way. I'll have it so you'll be dropped off at Sala to try and help with the public order.
Yes,
you're going to be picking up troops next turn from their coping. I should have Skara. You guys recruit some more stuff around there. And then let's see. Because I didn't actually prep up any units around here for you. I said I needed 6 more units, but I never grabbed them. So let's have you kind of go around up this way.
Of course, my lord.
Or towards Kugelsgrav. And then right now you have three cav units, four if you include the general, bunch of infantry, no skirmishers. So let's get, honestly, I want some of the mailed knights, some of these mounted mailed knights, some of the archers, and then honestly, probably that. So take the time to get those 6 units. Oh, actually, sorry, one less because I have that trebuchet. And then you guys are just sailing down. I'm going to make sure you guys don't get stuck.
Yes, my lord.
There you go. You're going to keep making your way down towards Africa. And then let's see that other fleet. So let's drop you off right around here. As I want to make sure that you guys aren't going to get stuck. Let's see, that was 1,000, 300, 0, 1 through 6, 700, 480, 960. I thought one of these mines was worth a lot. 720, 1,000. 500. Yeah, just go towards this. I think I am going to take these guys in Derpt. I'm going to bring them to try and group up with the Crown Prince. You guys can do that. I do have a couple guys in here I can maybe send down as well, because they're not attacking this area as frequently now. So let's grab these three. Try and also have them group up but down with us. And then I know I still have some buildings to do, so let's kind of go about. Let's see. So I know there was a few areas that actually had some build slots now. You guys might as well get the workshop catapult. You guys can't grow anymore, sadly. So I basically built that city up as much as I can right now. Oopsala. Let's see. I want something more for public order for you guys. I think, actually, let's try and get maybe the library of the school. That way I can try and get you guys better traits as a governor. The school takes less time, so let's kind of queue that up. And then what else can we get? Is that it? That is it for that. Okay. So let's end that turn around again. Keep bringing you guys down to see if I can try and still kill their faction leader for Novgorod with my assassin. If not, if I have enough time, I will probably just go and kill him with my faction leader right now. Take them down south, just go attack that city and just kill them off. As if I can take out their king, I have killed a lot of their family members. Maybe it's unlikely, but it's possible I can still try and kill them with just assassination and regicide. Kiev is another faction I maybe should try and do that with a little bit more. Although I haven't killed nearly as many of their faction leaders and family members in general. Let's see, I do need to start taking more of these guys. Even if some of these generals have some pretty bad loyalty, I still need to grab some more of them. Otherwise, I'm going to waste my daughters and marriable women off in my family. So we'll have to make sure we grab them. This guild I will grab for Riga. Pope is dead. Oh, shit. Interesting. Death of the Pope. has passed away, another area in history is completed. So, Vatican is rival new opportunities. Interesting. Let's see. I do get to vote. I can actually just vote for, let's see, Genoa, Holy Roman Empire, or Venice. I'm going to vote for the Holy Roman Empire. I want to make sure they like me, so I'm going to try and vote for them. And, come on, tell me who it is. Okay, Holy Roman Empire won. So I had three cardinals to throw towards that. I'm glad I chose the winning side, because they need to make sure those guys still love me, otherwise they might start another war with us. Sala, okay, Sala is happier. I do need to get some guys in here that are going to be free upkeep at some point. Need to try and do that. Money-wise, I'm making like 20,000 turn. Okay, we're still good there. You guys here, I'm going to have you grab the, get the rally, get that, so we can get the mailed knights as well around here. Then you guys keep recruiting some more men around there. Still can't train this cav unit just yet. Nope. And then how many turns until... two turns until you guys can get that. Although what I'll probably actually do is just have you guys grab some stuff around here. And then I can just send them, like, send you three down over this way. Try and put you guys in the Sala so I can bring these guys down. Probably bring them back down towards Turku. Or... I can have them make their way over towards Ladoga. I could try and do that. Now, I find it funny that you guys here, you are besieging my little fort there, which I'll probably just actually go out and kill you guys right now. Ah, they've got a lot of guys around here. Okay, well, I'm going to hope you guys can handle this on your own. What I'm going to be doing again is I want to gather my air together with a new force. There are some more stings right here. So if you guys merge those guys together, you guys, let's just kind of go by dirt. Yes. Get another watchtower around there. Bringing these lands under your gaze. And then, let's see. Oh, yes, just grab this. Yes. Because you have two more slots? No, three more slots. Let's grab another one of these Lithuanian archers. And then that is a full stack again for you. So what I'm going to have you do is, again, keep recruiting more guys around here. I'm going to have you hopefully now be able to make your way down towards here. I'll have you guys go towards Manx. Again, castles first. Oh, that's a city. I thought that was a castle down there. No, I will then... We've got a city here. That's just another city. I should have you guys go for the castle. And I know there's a castle at least over here, so I can try and have you guys go through. Actually, no, all of you liberate this. Liberate that, and then we can get keep moving along that way. Let's see. I am the highest production! Nice! I'm hoping that's going to stay this time. Family tragedy? No! Let's see. There's a lot of generals over here. Honestly, part of me is very tempted that I am getting this force together to go just absolutely wreck England's day. But also, part of me really wants to just say, you know what? Let's actually just start attacking and conquering over here. Because I think I kind of could take... I could take at least England and Winchester. I could do that. Take those. Have at least a little bit of a setup around here. Yes, base of operations that I can use. And slowly conquer into England. Although, honestly, I probably shouldn't. I should probably just focus solely on killing Russia right now. As I don't need to open up my front with the English right now. Now, your fleets here are almost ready. Oh, did I forget? I forgot to recruit them from here. Okay. Well, let's put the trebuchet onto the boat, and then I'll have it so next turn you guys will move out. I'm still waiting on more recruitment from here anyways. I'm going to send one of you guys. Also, no. Let's see. I'm going to send you over towards Skara. I know Skara could use a governor. And then also, I know Kalmar can use a governor, so I'll send you over there and there. And I forgot about these guys. Oh, fuck. That's what I was going to send over there. That's fine. I'm going to pick you guys up, send you back over this way. I sent you to the wrong area, so I'll send you guys back over to the east. And then you guys, let's drop you off. And then let's pick up you. And then, honestly, I don't know if I really want these mercenaries right around here. I was able to train some of them in other cities, and I don't know if there's a specific building I'm missing for that. There might be. Let's see. Visby. You guys are happy enough. I'm gonna get the tax office. Is that just gonna... that's adding all that on there. 200 in corruption. But you're gaining another 300 in trade, and another 200 from that. So I'd say that's worth it. Otherwise, what else can we build? You guys in Riga. We still don't have better units in these areas, do we? No, we don't. I think I'd rather you guys get the roads just so that we have a bit faster movement around here. Grab that. You guys are about to finish some roads up there. You guys are still sieged. Can you leave me the fuck alone, guys? Okay, try and repair that. I think that's it for buildings. Nope, there's one thing. You guys in Skara, definitely get the archery range. Grab that. Keep recruiting some more guys around here. And then I think that's it for buildings. Yes. Okay, so what we'll be doing is I'd say one more turn end. Oh, wait, what? Oh, they're just going to reconcile. Okay, that's what's going on. I'm still at least going to take the one city from England for sure. Because I might have been able to get away with a bit more war against them before, but now they've been reconciled into the kingdom, or into the church, I'm probably not going to be able to do that. You, let's build some more watchtowers around here, like there and there. And then I think, for the most part, I might actually be done for today now, as I want to fight this army, but I don't think I have enough time, so we'll just kind of quickly kill this guy off, get him out of this way, as I want to make sure we're using this little area to just gather some forces together that will watch over Novgorod as I try and push down, as right now, my primary targets for them are you. That's actually their capital. You... Actually, how many cities do they have? I haven't been paying attention to their territorial. I've just been paying attention to their military. Territorially, they have 7 regions. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I see 6 there. So we got one more somewhere that I just don't know of. I thought the worst. Okay, but no, sorry, got distracted. I am going to be done for today, as I do want to kind of leave off with this fight here. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, maybe like, comment, and or subscribe. If you guys did not, please let me know why so I can try and improve. Also, check out my Discord. It's a great way to interact with the rest of my community and get updates on videos. Additionally, there are plenty of other ways. Continue to my channel in the description, so you can check that out. That was Rampaned, and I'll see you guys next time.